So, hello and welcome to Pumpkin Roll Weekend. So today we're going to actually go through the steps of making the pumpkin roll batter and getting the bubbles out of the pan and before you put it in the oven, and then baking and rotating during baking, and when it comes out what it's supposed to look like out of the pan. The other stations will take care of the rolling and the frosting and the cooling, but today we're going to talk about mixing the batter. So, the first thing that we do is you make sure you have your recipe, which tells you to beat 6 room temperature eggs for 5 minutes. So, you drop your eggshell in there, be sure and fish out the shells. 2. Whoops, and see? So, like I said, be sure and fish out your shells. Because the only kind of crunchy we want in our pumpkin roll is pecans. All right, so we have all 6 eggs in there, and we are going to turn on our mixer. I usually like to beat it at about 5. And we beat for 5 minutes. So we will have oven time. We will have timers that you can use. But today I'm using my phone, so it'll tell me that when my 5 minutes is up. If you don't have a stand mixer, we'll have some available, but otherwise if you have a stand mixer, bring your own, because there is nothing like working with your own mixer. So we'll let that go, and in the meantime we will talk about the other things that are going to happen after we get done mixing. So after we mix the room temperature eggs for 5 minutes, we have our bag of granulated sugar that will go in next, and we'll show you how to do that. And then after that, you will stir in the 1 1/3 cup of pumpkin. So I'm going to go ahead and measure that out, and we will be using very large cans of pumpkin, not the little bitty ones.
Yeah, and I think just to chime in, I think one of the keys is multitasking, because, you know, you're going to need to keep up a pretty steady pace. And so if you can do other things while the eggs are blending and beating, that just gets you that much shorter of a time. You can finish up your shift and everybody can go home faster. So, yeah, she's kind of doing some measuring. Luckily, you'll have an assistant with you. So between the two of you, you can kind of prep or get multiple batches ready, kind of get things squared away so that you can, as quickly as possible, go from baking to another batch going in. So when you're done, this is basically what your eggs look like. Nice and frothy. They've been going for 5 minutes. This is basically what you'll know how they look like.
And turn down the speed on the mixer, and then take the bag of granulated sugar. There's already 2 cups measured out, and then you add it slowly, so that it gets mixed in with the eggs. And then once the sugar gets mixed in, you want to stir in your 1 1/3 cups of pumpkin and your 1 tablespoon of lemon juice. So make sure that's well mixed together. Then you take your bag of flour and spices that are already mixed. Open it up, and you'll probably have your assistant helping you with this. And I usually turn down the mixer so that the flour doesn't go everywhere. And then you add the flour and the spices in.
And just as a note, this amount of mix is pre-batched out to fit into 2 pans. The pans should already be prepared by another station for you, so you can kind of just get what's out of your bowl and pour it straight in and start the batches. That's why everything's pre-measured.
Then we take our lovely batter, which looks like that, and we divide it between the 2 pans. So what I usually like to do is put part of it in and then put part of it in the other pan, just to kind of see, okay, how much do I have? Do I have about the right amount? So, because basically you're evenly splitting it. So we set the bowl to the side, and then we can take and spread the batter out into the pan, into the corners. And yes, the batter will be very flat.
Yeah, which makes it a little bit challenging to make sure that you've spread it out evenly, because, you know, it's going to be rolled up, so it gets volume by just overlapping on itself. But if you don't have it even, it'll overbake in some areas, underbake in others. So definitely one of the key portions of this is just making sure it is gone into all the corners, make sure it's evened out, flattened out as much as you can get it. There's a little bit of just a process to it.
Part of baking pumpkin rolls is making sure that you get the air bubbles out of the batter. So we bang the pans. Which will also help to get it evened out.
Yeah, see, hers is much more uniform. Mine is still a bit lumpy in areas, and these parts where it's thinner will cook more or faster. So you definitely want to get it as evenly smoothed out as you can.
So you want it to be as even as absolutely possible, so that when it goes in the oven, it bakes even.
I was going to say, we want to get it even, but don't spend a crazy amount of time. We're doing it kind of for preparation and demonstration purposes here, but you'll want to be as quick as you can getting it into the oven, just because it is an assembly line, right? So you want to get it as quickly as you can into the oven and onto the next batch. It's just that in order to get the number done in the time we have, we got to keep it moving. So, and while this batch is cooking, you're basically going to be starting preparation on the next batch,
okay,
right?
Okay, so it says bake at 375 for 11 to 13 minutes. So we usually will rotate them at 7 minutes. So set your timer for 7 minutes. And then when the 7 minute timer goes off, then you'll take them out, rotate the pans, and flip the shelves.
Top and bottom, yeah.
So you'll flip top and bottom, and you'll spin the pans.
Yep.
So we'll do that in 7 minutes. Okay, so our 7 minutes are up. We're gonna open the oven, and we're going to take our pumpkin roll off of the bottom shelf, put it on the door, and we'll take our pumpkin roll off the top shelf, rotate it around, stick it on the bottom shelf, push the bottom shelf back in, take the one from the top shelf, rotate it around, and put it back in, and close the door and reset our timer for 5 minutes.
All right, so here's an example. We pulled one out kind of prematurely just to show you. It's kind of goldeny, but not brown goldeny. So it's a little underdone. We're going to put it back in for another minute and give it a little more time to go. These ovens can be real particular, so we just wanted to kind of show you what a in-progress state goes.
So when you look at the bottom, you don't want it to be light yellow. You want it to be really more golden, kind of a brown, like the color of a lion. And the top needs to be not tacky. So it needs to be baked so that if you do this, nothing comes off.
Mm-hmm.
So the top may be a little bit more done than the bottom, but you see the bottom on this one is a little bit more done, which is part of the reason that we rotate the pans in the oven. So, and see, it's a little more done on that side. So these are good rolls, and they will then go to the next station to be taken, to cool a little bit off the pans and be taken off of the parchment paper and then rolled up.
Rolled,
and
frosted,
and
all the other steps.
All the other fun stuff.
But yeah, essentially the thing to remember is that you're going to need to go from pulling the pan out, you're going to need to start another batch within about 2 minutes. So you're going to definitely need to be...
You want to make sure that you are already mixing another
batch. Yeah, you're already mixing, exactly.
So as soon as these pans come out, the next set of pans is ready to go in.
Correct.
so that you're continuously, there's always a pumpkin roll pan in the oven.
Yep. Yep. Very good.